I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, I'll show you how to fix the problem where your Wi-Fi mostly works on your iPhone, but you can't update apps, and you see a no internet connection next to your wireless network name. I'll walk through the steps I recently used to fix this problem. I don't expect this solution to work for everyone, but hopefully this helps some people out. Step 1. Access your router settings and locate the DNS server information. In this example, I've got a Netgear Nighthawk router, so I'll look up this information in the Nighthawk app. To find the DNS server information in the Nighthawk app, I'll tap the menu icon at the top of the screen, Settings, then Router Settings, and then Internet Port. You can find the DNS server numbers in the DNS server section. Write down any of the sets of numbers associated with your DNS server. You'll need these numbers later. Step 2. Open the Settings app on your iPhone or iPad, and then tap Wi-Fi in this menu. In line with your problem, you'll currently see a No Internet Connection message located directly beneath the name of the wireless network that you're connected to. Tap the name of that Wi-Fi network. The information screen associated with that wireless network is displayed. Step 3. Scroll down this menu to the DNS section and then tap Configure DNS. The Configure DNS screen opens. Step 4. Tap to place a checkmark next to Manual. You'll now see a section where you can add and remove DNS servers. Step 5. Tap the minus sign and then tap Delete to delete any DNS servers that are currently in this section. Step 6. Tap Add Server in the DNS section and enter one of the sets of DNS numbers you wrote down previously. Repeat this process until all of your DNS server numbers are entered. Step 7. Tap Save to save your entered DNS information. After a few minutes, you'll hopefully see that the No Internet Connection message underneath of your Wi-Fi name has gone away and your connection is working normally. If this doesn't work, I'd advise going back into the DNS section on your iPhone, setting it back to manual, and continuing to try other troubleshooting methods to resolve your issue. Let me know if this video helped you out in the comments below. If you liked what you saw here, click the video links on the right side of the screen to check out another video. Or click the logo on the left side of the screen to check out my tutorial website at www.maxdalton.how.